are monitoring the coast as hundreds of dead fish continue to wash ashore.
Many of you have been reporting these fish washing up behind your homes and on the shores of Mobile Bay since late last week. Today, officials are back out working to find out why it's happening.
Fox 10 News reporter Corey Pippen looked into what's known about these mysterious deaths.
It's a sight many continue to see. Hundreds of fish washing up dead on beaches or just floating in the water from the eastern shore to Fort Morgan. And it's not something folks are getting used to, including Brian Hill, site director for the Fort Morgan State Park.
The smell is pretty bad, and the people have been complaining constantly since Friday that the beach is a mess and that we should clean it up. And I don't have the staff, the equipment to clean up this beach.
The fish, primarily redfish with some catfish, are usually found dead with no obvious signs of trauma, with only a few reported cases of disabled fish being seen.
It's sad. It's very sad. They're just washed up here, and I don't even know what killed them.
We stopped by the Alabama Marine Resources Division in Gulf Shores to find out if they know why it's happening. Chief Biologist Kevin Anson says crews have been trying to find the answer to that question since 2012. He says catfish are often prone to viruses. However, the redfish deaths are puzzling.
It could be serious, or certainly, you know, the event occurring at the same time. You know, now it's the second year in a row. So, you know, if it happens next year, then you have a fairly significant trend. And so you would need to be, you know, diligent to look at what factors in the environment that may be causing that.
He says boats were out on the water today looking for live fish or freshly dead fish for testing. Anson says the fact that similar events happened last year around the same time could actually make it easier for them to figure out just what's going on. And he says figuring out water conditions could be a big piece to the puzzle.
We may be able to piece together through looking at some of the environmental observations and other data and tie that and compare it from last year to this year. And then if it happens again next year, we'll have a fairly large data set, and we can do some sort of analysis and, you know, maybe make fairly educated guesses.
Until then, it's just wait and see. Reporting from Baldwin County, Corey Pippen, Fox 10 News.
And officials plan to send water samples to the Alabama Department of Public Health for testing.